Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so glad to see you all here at Antone's. And we gather one more time, going out at night in the dark to this strange, not quite clean room to be shoulder to shoulder with strangers. Where we can worship the mystery.
Burn!
Oh my goodness! The internet's here!
Hi, internet!
Hi, internet! I didn't know you were going to stop by today. We're very excited, though, because we have these instruments, and we're locked in quarantine, and so we're looking for someone to take it out on, and that's you!
Hello!
You're lucky enough to bear the brunt of our quarantine this particular instant, and we appreciate it so much. And so we play you some songs?
Yeah.
Yes, let us play some songs. That's what we're good for. Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see.
Jesus Christ, they taught my heart to fear.
Now. the sacred and profane all are available to you here on the internet and for free. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
I found an applause thing.
Yes, thank you, thank you, thank you. Our studio audience are arranged here in the Enorma Dome as we send out our broadcast at 200 billion watts, enough to fry everyone in the tri-state area. And why? Because you deserve to be entertained, and you deserve to be entertained. And all of you, it deserve to be entertained. And so we are here to do battle on the field of music for your enjoyment, because that's just what we do. These are weird times that we're in. I don't have to tell you that. You're on the internet. You already know. But what's particularly interesting about this time is the twin-headed snake of both the pandemic and the fabulous
Black Lives Matter movement.
Well, yeah. It's like because I was just talking with a friend at a distance recently, and we were talking about how this is actually a tremendously inspirational and exciting time to be alive. Mm-hmm. The Black Lives Matter movement is the largest movement with the more people in the street than at any time in American history. Yeah. That's remarkable. It's unfortunate that it has to happen right now during this pandemic, but also it's a bill that's coming due. Because
they deserve to be equal.
These are complicated questions, and we realize that. And we don't want to spend too much time proselytizing about all of this. But on the other hand, right is right, and good is good, and evil is evil. And racism, well, that's evil.
That's racism.
Now, I'm a white guy who grew up in a primarily white environment and still feels sometimes uncomfortable around people who are different than me because I'm not sure what to expect.
What's that called? That's called systemic?
Yeah, systemic. But it's a real thing.
Yeah.
Now, my experiences showed me, and also a very casual study of history, that that the science totally supports the realization that humans are equal and that you can have a genius and an idiot, and it doesn't matter what color they are. It's still possible. There are a lot of advantages and stuff like that that someone in my position might have had through their life that someone else who had a skin of a different color living in this country would not. And why is that? Well, there's a lot of different things behind it. But slavery and the conditions that existed for hundreds and hundreds of years have all added up to that. Now, that doesn't mean... what am I trying to say? Well, I'm trying to say is that there are no restricted signs in heaven. I was trying to say that. It just wasn't coming out of my mouth.
Well, you said it. Yeah, Let's sing it. If us talking about anything racist and saying that people deserve to be equal upsets you, we kindly invite you to farewell. And we hope that you will take this time to learn and read and educate yourself.
Knock a knock a knock knock.
Knock knock.
Folks are knocking on the pearly gates. So knock 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 knock. Ask about a rule about the race. Knock a knock a knock knock. Folks are knocking on the pearly gates. So knock 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 knock. Ask about a rule about the race. Now old Saint Peter was a vision reader. He was present to let them in. Some looked down because his skin was round, but Pete hollered with a great big grin. You're welcome. There's no restricted signs in heaven. Brother, brother, that good double. Hallelujah. Knock, 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 knock. Pete said, hey, why don't you follow me? Knock, 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 knock. And looked around, and what did they see? Snow White angels, color angels, sons of David and Chinese. You're happily swelled up at this hotel. You can even check in your dungarees. You're welcome. Welcome. There are no restricted signs in heaven. No selective clientele. There's no restricted signs in heaven. Brother, brother, that good devil. Hallelujah. Knock, 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 knock. Pete, he knocked upon a door of stone. Knock, knock, knock. There was the Lord upon a simple throne, and he looked like Moses
and he looked like Buddha, and he looked like the Savior, so good and kind, and he spoke to the young in their native tongue.
In heaven, no select clientele. There's no string of signs in heaven, brother, brother. That good devil, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yes,
well, that felt good.
That did feel good.
So, you know what feels good in the morning? The truth.
We've got lots of people saying hi.
Hi,
so let's say we've got Mark, hi from Cincinnati. Tim Sterk, hi from Holland. Julian Knowles, hi. We love seeing you here. We've missed you too. We took a couple days off there while we tried to figure out how to do the TV show thing. David Wilson, hi. Nice to see you here. Danielle Antonis is checking in from Holland. Monica's checking in from Midland, Odessa. We've got Heather Hooper. Bonnie, hi.
Tim thinks I should run for president.
I was just telling Guy I think that he should run for city council the other day. Start somewhere.
Yeah.
Lots to say and well spoken. And the reason that we're talking about it so much this show, we usually don't, but we are today because I made the mistake of having an opinion on my Facebook shortly before we started the show. and you know, I really believe... Mercy. Do what? Mercy now? Yep. Yeah. I really believe that people should be allowed to be friends with those that don't believe the same as them. That's fine. I've just kind of gotten to the point where I keep arguing with the same people over and over again, and nothing changes, except I'm just increasingly upset. So I have kindly invited people that just aren't interested in learning and aren't interested in being progressive and aren't interested in equality to just kindly leave my Facebook. And so if we have some interesting comments today, that's why. And we'll just ignore them and move on because I'm not interested in arguing with anyone. I'm arguing for equal rights. I'm interested in that. That's what we're interested in.
That's right. We are on Freedom's Highway here. Mm-hmm. And all of these terms, like the term Freedom Highway, we didn't come up with these. This is actually a tradition now in the United States. For as long as I have been alive, people have been marching for equal rights, and they still don't have them. So, we continue marching.
Which includes our youngest daughter, Bella Jane.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, they got more highs. Hi, Kim Snell. John Farley, hi. Sissy Simone. Yeah, y'all stay tuned. We're gonna do a fun giveaway today. But before that, we're going to sing some songs that might help make you think. And this is a Mary Gauthier tune. This is Mercy Now. My father could use a little mercy now. The fruits of his labor slowly falling right to the ground. His work's almost over. Soon he won't be around. I love my father. He could use some mercy now. My brother, use a little mercy now. He's a prisoner to freedom, shackled by his fear and his doubt.
Hi, Aunt Kathleen.
The pain that he lives with is more than living alive.
church and my country could use a little mercy now. Sink into a poison pit, it's gonna take forever to climb out.
I'm climbing right now.
Carry the weight of the faithful, follow them down. Love my church and country, we could use some mercy now.
I'm gonna play a little cylinder here. Certainly could use some mercy right now. While I was getting ready, I was thinking about something the other day that was said to me or about me for the first time, and it's someone just wrote that I'm an activist.
You should be proud of that.
Which was great. And then I just decided in the bathroom, I was thinking, like, what would I like people to remember me by? What would I, if I'm doing some genealogy work for my family right now, and what's interesting is that I can trace us all the way back to the 1500s. But there's nothing about those people other than one word sometimes. Sometimes you can find one word that has made it 400 years that describes them.
Stinky.
And I think that I'd like for mine to be something along the lines of activist.
Yeah, I think...
Progressive. Your grandfather, your grandpa, right?
Which
is excellent.
Something I'm very proud of. My grandfather, on my mom's side, was the president of the University of Houston, Philip Hoffman. And he oversaw the change of the institution from being a private, white-only university to a public university that was integrated. And he said that was the thing that he was proudest of his entire life. And I think that that's a beautiful thing. I guess, really, the plan here is to just try to leave the world a little bit better than the way it was that we found it.
Which is really how you should look at most aspects in your life. How should we leave that? The same or better than we did when we got it?
Yes.
So, sorry we're a little preachy today. We're a little bit Sunday brunch day. Woo! This is our European, what have I been calling it? I've been calling it our European brunch show.
European brunch show.
Because it's too long to have all the things. But we're going to do this every Sunday now, which is going to be very exciting. Now I'm going to be a scary ghost.
Ooh.
I went down to old Joe's barroom on the corner by the square. Drinks they were served as usual, and the usual crowd was there. Over on my left sat Big Joe McKinnis. His eyes were bloodshot red. They were always bloodshot red. He turned with a sad expression. These are the very words he said. Said, I went down St. James Infirmary. I was gonna go see my baby there. They had him stretched out on a long white table. So alone, so cold, so bare. Well, let her go, let her go. Search out of hallelujah. Oh, we're never gonna find a man loving as sweet as me. Oh. Stetson hat. You could put a Susan B. Anthony on my watch chain, so the gang knows I died standing back. Well, I want six pack shooters for pallbearers. I want pretty girl to sing your song, yeah. I'll put a jazz band on my road. This wagon gon' raise hallelujah as we strum. I'm gonna help myself do another shot of your booze. And if anyone should happen to ask you, oh, you can tell them I got the St. James Infirmary. Mm-hmm.
Yay!
Thank you. Thank you.
That was awesome.
I see you up there.
Sorry. People are probably like, why is she so distracted? What is she doing on
her
phone?
What is she doing?
Well, I was just pinning on the live feed where you can donate if you want to. And we say if you want to because we know that we are in a financial situation right now. We can't donate for all the things. But we're trying to figure out ways to make it fun for those that can donate. And also, please, if you aren't donating and can't donate, please continue watching. We want you here.
Absolutely. These are really weird times. And some people are choosing, even before quarantine, some people were choosing to stay in, even though that meant not being able to make money. That is the right thing to do in a pandemic situation like this. early on, we realized I spray a lot when I sing.
I can post some videos where y'all can see it's like ka-choo.
Yeah, yeah. Some people talk about being in the splash zone if you're enough. And I don't mean to be rude, but it's but also that's the way that it's done. And so if I had the virus, I might give it to those that I care about the most, which of course my family, my friends, and the people who come see us play music. And I just can't have that happening. Yeah. So we've been staying in and not making... I spent my whole entire life as a live performer. That's what I have done my entire life. That's how I've made my money. And that's the skill set that I've got. But now is not the time for live performance. Now is the time to experiment with the internet.
And that's what we're doing today. So while we have you all gathered here, we're going to do a giveaway.
A giveaway?
A giveaway. And so how you can be entered in for this lovely raffle giveaway at no additional cost to you is if you send a donation to us today. At the end of the show, we're going to look through all of it, and I'm going to do a random number calculator on my phone. Pick a number, and whoever donated right there is what will get this. So if you were like the fifth person to donate mm-hmm. today, and we pick number 5 on the random number like generator, mm-hmm. then you win this. And that's we'll right. sign it, we'll write some funny things on it, or send it to whoever you want, and we'll pay for the postage.
This is Conspirators. This is the record that Jess and I put out last year, which is an all acoustic CD. Similar to what we're doing today. In fact, we are going to do some more songs from that very recording. And so you can know. And also, if you already have that record, well, get another one and give it to your friends.
So if you can donate, please do. This album sells for $20. So if you just feel like, oh, I really think I'm going to win it, I'm going to give an extra $20. You know, that's fine with us too. And of course, as always, if you can't donate... or if you just don't want to, we won't know the difference, and you can watch the show for free. Please share, please subscribe. If you have people that would like to watch that aren't on Facebook, we are now streaming every one of these shows on YouTube Live as well, and they're going to be all there for you to watch and just cataloged there for you.
Well, we'd like to move from our era of moral superiority to one of inferiority and talk about our love for true crime.
I love true crime. I'm glad that you brought that up.
So are there any murderinos out there in the audience? People who are fans of true crime? That does not necessarily mean that you're fans of crime, but you're definitely interested, perhaps even morbidly.
On the wrong camera.
Morbidly.
Your mom was like, wrong camera, Jessica!
Morbidly fascinated with crime. And we're going to combine that with our love of roots music. And so here's a nice folk song for you with a grisly ending.
Which one is it?
Delia.
Oh.
Oh, yes. Delia's gone.
Keep talking about crime.
Oh, Delia. Oh, Delia. Delia all my life. Now, if I had a shot for Delia, I'd have had her to be my wife. Delia's gone. One more round. First time I shot her in the side. Now it's hard to watch her suffer, but with the second shot she died. Delia's gone, one more round, Delia's gone. I went up to Memphis, and I found Delia there. I caught down and traveling. She was cold and mean, the kind of woman made me want to grab my submachine. Delia's gone, one more round. Delia's
jailer, I can't sleep. 'Cause all around my bedside, I hear the paddle of Delia's feet. Delia's gone, one more round, Delia's gone. Now, if your woman's devilish, you can't let her run. Or you can bring her down just like Delia got done. Remember, crime is bad.
Crime is bad, but I found some crime ladies. Yay!
Do they have to be ladies?
They don't have to be ladies. You can be a murderino.
You can be a
submarine.
A submarine.
You can be a submarine and still like true crime.
Murderina?
Murderino is it doesn't make
doesn't have a gender. Yeah, doesn't have a gender. Okay.
So you can be that. Hi, Steve. Steve's here. Mom, thank you for watching and helping me not look as special as we all know that I am. here in just a minute, we'll check on donations today, and we will make this just super fun for whoever wins it, and we'll write on it live on camera, and you can be like, hey, look at when Guy and Jess wrote all over this thing that I have now.
We're going to put a check for $200 billion in here.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be written on Monopoly money. Yeah. Da, da, da. Meh, meh, meh.
So pick a song off there and we'll sing it.
Ooh, let's see. Let's do this, the fun. We already did the last one. So but someone online, comment with a number between 1 and 11, and that's the one that we'll do. Except for your mom, because she probably has the numbers memorized. She knows what she's
there. Yeah.
Sorry, Mom.
She does
so, that. But this is my first album that I shot, edited, designed, and did all of the things for myself. So I'm pretty proud of that. So if you know anyone that needs album art designed, I know a girl that's hustling, mm-hmm. trying to make some money during the COVID. That's me.
Yes, if you'd like a nice picture done in stained glass, you could also.
Yeah, and I can basically learn whatever it is.
I can make up limericks, so if you need a limerick made up, I can.
Eight. It's by Joy McCroy Logue Courtney, pick number 8, which is Sing About It.
If you get to worry, what you ought to do is sing. If you get worried, what you ought to do is sing. If you get worried, what you ought to do is sing. Sing about your trouble, it just might pass. And if you get lost, what you ought to do is sing. If you get lost, what you ought to do is sing. If you get lost, what you ought to do is sing. Sing about your troubles, they just might pass. Sing about your troubles, they just might pass. Sing about joy. Sing about love and hope and it lasts. Sing about your troubles.
Get broken.
What you ought to do is sing. If you get broken, what you ought to do is sing. If you get broken, what you ought to do is sing. Sing about your troubles with just might pass. Sing about your troubles with just might pass. Sing about joy. Sing about love and hope and it lasts. Sing about your troubles.
Joy.
Sing about love and hope. Just might pass.
Yay, thank you. That was awesome.
So is it this phone?
Is this phone?
Is it that the one? Is it that phone?
No.
Which phone is on? There.
I don't know. Maybe I should just read all the directions people tell me while I'm on live.
We put all the stuffed animals in the room, and they're all looking at us. So it's because
actually we have pictures of our entire family all right there on
that's,
the
camera. That's true. And they're looking at us too and judging us.
Probably. So,
it's just the way
our
of
families.
The world. It's just the way of the world.
Hmm. I like that one. I'm gonna go zoom in on the camera to you.
That evening sun go down. I hate to see that evening sun go down. Well, it makes me feel I'm on my last go round. Feeling tomorrow just like I feel today. Tomorrow, just like I feel today. I'm gonna pack my grip, make my getaway. Oh, St. Louis woman with a diamond ring leads a man around by her apron string. I can't be. Woman's got a heart like a rock thrown in the sea. Oh, she would not have gone oh so far from me. But I was that scab soup by in the sea. Oh, she would not have gone oh so far from me.
Oh, I'm coming back.
The St. Louis Blues.
Checking on PayPal. Sorry. Let's run around in front of everybody. I'm making sure to keep track of donations and
that's
stuff.
Nice.
So we have some already coming in. We've got Lori Dawson, David
Thank you
Wilson,
all very much. Thank
Morgan
you very much.
Melt, Elizabeth Simon, Susan Burnson, Bonnie Holder, Evelyn Button, and Stephen Gallion, all just today, which is
the crops so great. Are saved!
Well, I mean, I really appreciate it, guys. We did a show, and we're grateful for everything we get. If it was a dollar, we'd be grateful for it.
That's
it's just
absolutely
stuff.
True.
The other day, we'll have one show, and we'll get three donations, and then sometimes we get like 10, and so it we really appreciate it. Thank you.
Yep, we're doing what we can, and we appreciate you doing what you can. Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'm writing these down. I'm not trying to ignore everybody. I'm gonna put the thing back on you, so you're looking at the robot. Hello, also, Robot Bonnie Cam. Holder, thank you. You donated, but really, you're good for life because Bonnie Holder sent us her old iPhone 6, which we are using to do the streams that you see. And we named it the Bonnie Phone.
Hi, Bonnie.
And Robot Cam and Brenda Cam are on today. Those are also donated phones that were sent to us. And Brenda, I mean, Bonnie Cam needs an update. But thank you. Thank you. All right. It's all you, babe. I'm going to work on this here. All
right. Well, then I guess.
This is a weird.
We could play a little music. So for Leo, I was asking, is that dadgad? Am I playing a dadgad? It's close. It's vestrapol, which is similar, but instead of dadgad, which would be And these are the notes on the guitar. D, A, D, F sharp, A, G. So instead of dad gad, which would make this note here, like that, it's tuned to an open chord. An open tuning, it's an open major chord where you're playing the 1, the 3, or the 1, the 5, the 1, the 3, the 5, the 1. There we go.
Request.
What's that?
Well, Julie Ann Knowles has a request, and she says she's all out of dollars, which is fine.
That's
she's
fine.
Here us all too. The time, and she tips us just plenty, and mm-hmm. we appreciate you being here, so don't mm-hmm. feel bad about it. You're good. She wants to hear Things That Matter.
Oh, sure.
And she's doing like the little begging sign, and
oh, absolutely. Let's do it.
We love you. We'll do it.
This is a song that I wrote with Brian Keene. I wrote it while I was in Nashville writing with Brian. Brian's a great songwriter and a great guy, and I think he was planning on coming back to Austin sometime soon.
Oh, really?
But all of that is pre-COVID news, so everything, we realize that everything is going to take a little break for a little while. But I really look forward to getting back together with Brian Keene.
Have I met him?
I don't think you have.
It'd be nice to meet him.
I think you have. He's been living in Nashville.
Yeah.
But this is a song that I wrote for Stephen Bruton. Stephen Bruton was a great musician.
And Sissy Simone also wants it. I'm sorry. It's also important for her that we say that it's for her, too.
It's also for Sissy.
Sissy.
You got it. And this song was written for Stephen Bruton.
Thank you.
It don't matter when they are not there. Now I know you can tell I'm not a rich man. Specs, you know I'm not a rich man's son. And play, get roses while you may. Can't buy your time back when it's done. I only want the things that matter. Only want things to don't give me diamond rings. All those so-called finer things, they don't matter when they.
A beautiful song.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. I just shared the Patreon link, which we're going to be doing our first Patreon members only concert for this month, mm-hmm. which is exciting. It's on the 21st, mm-hmm. which I think is during the week at 7 p.m. And if you're a patron on Guy's Patreon page, you get to see the show, which will be great. And what's fun about the Zoom, which is the platform we'll use for this, is we can have an interactive experience. So there will be a place where you can ask questions or just chat with Guy. People really love telling about when they met him. Their stories like that are fun. But it's an interactive experience. So if that sounds like something that you would enjoy, please check out Guy Forsyth on patreon.com. And that's just one of like the kajillion perks that we have.
Well, have we put up the harmonica lesson?
Yeah, we did.
So at a certain tier, I'll be teaching harmonica, how to play harmonica for both beginners and advanced students. Mm-hmm. And we'll also have things about the different instruments that we play. So if you are interested in starting to learn how to play an instrument, now is a perfect time. Got a little time on your hands, a little spare time.
Right. Yeah. And it's labeled as Guy Forsyth Patreon. Mm-hmm. But I'm on there too, doing stuff too. There's a couple tiers where if you're a patron for like 3 or 6 months in a row, that I'll send you a custom made piece of artwork, which is fun. And if anyone out there really wants to learn beginner, like very beginner, like you've never touched an instrument, ukulele or guitar, I could be coerced into making some instructional videos myself. But only if like your child wants to learn or if you have never tried.
Well, why don't you play us a song on the ukulele?
Oh, sure. That's what I was hoping would happen. Silly Billy. I see all of those donations coming in. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
And know that we're not the only musicians that are taking to the internet. Go to Austin 360 and you can see the lineup for all the live streams of all the folks.
We're also lucky, of course, that we are...
we have you guys.
We're singers and that we can just hold an instrument and play, and we're lucky we have the phones and all the infrastructure that allows us to do this. But there are a lot of musicians that don't. Say, for example, if you're a drummer or a bass player, it's not nearly as easy to just start shilling on the internet like we are. But we're going to do our TV show coming up.
On Wednesday,
where we are going to shine a light on the fabulous musicians that we usually get to play with when we're on tour around the world. And so that should give us an opportunity to talk about them. And that show we're going to do as a benefit for our...
I'm thinking that our wonderful musicians we work with need another week. So that one's getting pushed a week out. So this Wednesday is going to be a surprise show because I haven't gotten anything from them
all
yet.
Hand puppets.
I need 100%. All 15 of Guy's musicians to please send me the material I requested via email so ASAP.
So we can give you the lifeline.
Yeah.
That
so this week we will do a story on Guy Forsyth and take a look into his family. I think that you have a super interesting family.
I think I have a super interesting family too. I'm like just the weird artsy one. You know, there's the true noble one, and then there's the really hot, good-looking one.
Oh, I know. Okay. I know who all these people are.
Would you hand me this song?
Your sister's watching.
Hey, sister.
Sister is the hot, noble one.
The hot, noble one.
I win. So I imagine I'm doing Downpour, huh?
Whatever you like.
Yeah. It's the only one I know by heart. So I've only been playing instruments for, I think, getting close to 3 years now, right? Two and a half years, 3 years? When Guy and I first started dating, I didn't play any instruments and very quickly realized I was going to have to learn to play an instrument one way or another.
Absolutely have to.
So I started taking guitar lessons in San Angelo by Jimmy Shanks, who's an awesome music instructor. And now I can play the saw and the uke and the guitar, but all minimally. This was the first song I ever tried to learn. And I hope I play it right and with a lead in like that. Sounding good?
Sounds so good so far. Careful. Oh, you got it.
So pretty.
On the Patreon account, we'll also do a lesson on how to play
the saw.
Yeah. Amuse your friends. Keep your limbs.
Yeah. I saw. You said I said I saw.
Well, it's finally gotten hot in Texas. How hot is it outside right now?
So.
How hot is it? It's so. So,
what are you doing?
Do 105. It's a song I wrote with Mark Addison. At 9 a.m., it was 105. And I started looking for a place to hide. Well, I went down to the edge of town, right down to the riverside. Well, I got down to the riverside. And there was a man in a coat and tie, even though it was 105. Behind a brand new 10-foot barbed wire fence, his attorney by his side. And he said, this river is spoken for. This river is spoken for. This river don't belong to you no more. Well, I went back to my old neighborhood with a hole in the ground where my house once stood. A 10-ton truck, a jackhammer crew, and a pile of splintered wood. And sure enough, right there he stood. That man in a coat and tie was 105. And he said, on these remains, we're gonna build 10 lanes, a big box on each side. And he said, this land is spoken for. This land is spoken for. This land don't belong to you no more. Was 110, and I didn't want to see that man again, so I curled up and died.
It's reasonable.
When I got to St. Peter's gates, guess who was by his side? That man in a coat and tie. There was a padlock on the promised land and a wad of cash in St. Peter's hand as he waved goodbye. And he said, your wings are spoken for, your wings are spoken for, you don't belong anymore. So I turned around and I went back down where the river drained through a hole in the ground. I got my own little pyre on the lake of fire, least I can call it mine. 9 a.m. was 199.
I just haven't used a tambourine, tambourine in 5 months now.
I know, you gotta be careful of these things. You can really hurt somebody.
That's the quiet one. This one here.
Yes. Good heavens.
Now I'm used to like this. Now we're gonna go play our first show, like probably next year. Hi, everybody. In public. But when we play in public, it's gonna be like just traumatizing to me. So loud!
I can't wait for some good trauma.
Oh, I can't wait either. All right.
What are we going to play now?
I don't know. Let's see. Does anyone have any requests? I'm trying to not dump all those tambourines on the floor. Beautiful Mistake. Lori Dawson would love Beautiful Mistake.
Sure. Let's do that one.
Good call. Just check out this Tom Waits. How to Tom Waits.
How to Tom Waits.
And for
First,
those that are just joining.
Bury yourself for 16 years. Gargle with Drano.
Look mad forever. He looks habitually angry.
Nonsense. He looks, you know, more insane than angry.
Today we're doing this this giveaway. For those that donate, we will be doing a drawing and sending a signed CD to you. So I guess if you really want to, you could think of it like a raffle, you know? Like you're paying for a raffle ticket, if you will. But yeah, the CD will go out to whomever it is that is selected at the end of the show today. And if you can't donate, it's okay. We love you very much. We love you equally. And understand that you're going through hard times. So please hit share. Subscribe to us on YouTube and Instagram and all of the grams. And Instas and live streams. So did you write this one about?
This is another song that I wrote with Mark Addison
and
Nina Singh. And this is a song about one of those dangers that can happen close to home. Because you might have it all figured out. Got yourself your little hot two-seater convertible car just big enough for you and your dog.
That means you'll have a kid.
And things are going just great. And then you might just bump into somebody and your life is in chaos. Caught up in a conversation with a stranger in a subway station. Can't remember where I'm supposed to be. Pushing through the turnstile ladder with all the suits and alligators. I feel someone brush up next to me. Then I see you, and it blinds me with your mama's rhinestones in your thrift store finery. I've been wandering in the dark looking for someone to find me. When I close my eyes, it's only you I'm thinking of. I don't know why I try to be so tough. So tough, a heart that will not break. It's not enough. It's not enough. What a beautiful mistake to fall in love. To fall in love. Haunted all the usual places. Felt and frayed is how I feel. In the crowd I'm still a part, the only one with a beating heart. With the tears and stains to make it real. You and I, we are the same. Faded pictures in a broken frame. And I don't even know your name. When I close my eyes, it's only you I'm thinking of. I don't know how I try.
only you I'm thinking of. I don't know why I try to be so tough, to be so tough. A heart that will not break, it's not enough, it's not enough. What a beautiful mistake to fall in love, to fall in love.
I can hear everyone singing along with you. They're quoting your lyrics in the comment sections while you're singing it. And you know what? I think that's super beautiful. I think that's great.
It is very nice.
I feel like I can hear them like singing with you.
I see a request from my sister. Bridget and I want to hear Mad World.
Lord. I mean, if y'all don't care if it's right or good. My poor guitar. It's mine now. I got it. It's mine. I decided to keep her.
So we're going to do this song. Where did you hear this song first?
Mad World? Mm-hmm. On that bunny movie.
That bunny movie. Was it Watership Down?
No. It was, I think Donnie Darko is the name of that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a profoundly sad movie. And this song just, some songs don't have any choice but to have feelings. Mm-hmm. This song has feelings. It's got big feelings. I haven't practiced this in like 3 weeks, so.
And we will not be using a net. So it's
can you tune
possible
this?
If you have children watching.
Quickly. I can tune it. I
definitely
just
not want to let them see this.
I'm looking for my big
unless it's Bridget, who I think. You
which
know.
Bridget? Little Bridget or Big Bridget?
I think it's Little Bridget.
Little Bridget. Thank you for donating. We've got 10 donations today.
Thank you so much.
That is just, it's so great that we get to do this and that we're still making some sort of income, so thank you.
Thank you, because although hungry musicians do play better for a while, eventually it tapers off and then starts to get worse, so.
I thought this was capoed. This is what happens when you don't practice.
It's true.
I haven't practiced this song in a minute. I'm going to do it, though.
Are you going to capo it?
I'm
going to
see if I like it capoed, and then I'll make a decision. Because I think I did something weird last time when I sang it, it just sounded real bad. And I can't remember if I capoed it or not. This doesn't say capo, so I'm going to not do it.
So you're not going to capo?
Oh, yes, I am. Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
Okay, you are. So.
Y'all, the font is this big. It took me a second to see. All right. And no more excuses to go. Here we go.
Familiar faces, worn out places.
It made you emotional.
Well, I mean, I'm already emotional.
I'm going to play the one that makes me emotional.
Okay. Thanks, Liz.
Look what you did. I hope you're happy now.
No, thank you. Today's been an emotional day.
Got a letter from a messenger. Read it when it came. Said that you were wounded. You were bound in chains. You were loved and you were handled. You were poisoned, you were pained. Touch heaven right there in front of you. Liberty just slipped away on us. Now there's so much work to do. But the door that closes tightly is the door that can swing wide. Oh no, not expecting to collide. For a minute I let my guard down, not afraid to be found out. That love will take it. This desire I can't kill. Here's my heart, please don't break it. I will crawl to your foothill. I'm frightened, but I'm coming.
Now you talk. I'm gonna go dry up. Right. Oh man, I'm gonna go write down the rest of the donations now. So if any of you out there would like to make a donation, now's the chance to be in the running for the free CD that we will mail to you. It's actually just a CD that you paid for, kinda. That we're gonna mail to you for free, but
hey, free postage.
Play that song now. Thank you.
Many is the time I've been mistaken, and many times confused. Yes, and I've often felt forsaken, and certainly misused. I'm all right, I'm all right, I'm just
to be bright and bountiful, so far away from home, so far away from home. I don't know a soul who's not been battered. I don't have a friend who feels at ease. Don't know a dream that's not been shattered or driven to its knees. But I'm alright, I'm alright. We've lived so well so long. Still, when I think of the road we're traveling on, I wonder what's gone wrong. Can't help it, I wonder what's gone wrong. And I dreamed I was dying. I dreamed that my soul rose unexpectedly, looking back down at me, smiled reassuringly. I was flying, and high up above, my eyes could clearly see the Statue of Liberty sailing away to sea. And I dreamed I was flying. We come on the ship they call the Mayflower. Come on a ship that sailed the moon. Come in the age's most uncertain hour and sing an American tune. Oh, but it's alright, it's alright, it's alright. You can't be forever blessed. Still, tomorrow's gonna be another working day, and I'm trying to get some rest. That's all I'm trying, to get some rest. Paul Simon.
That's beautiful.
Ah, so good. So good. Oh, how I wish. How I want. There's a certain file of songs, or the songs that you wish that you wrote, you know. But nevertheless, it's a pleasure to get to sing them. Like, it's a pleasure to speak the truth. And so, as you go through your day, look for opportunities to speak the truth. Do what you can.
Yes, that's the emotional thing that we're going through today. I don't want anyone to think Guy and I are fighting. We're not. I mean, today. Don't do that. Stop touching me. Stop it. But we have a lot of bigger emotions because people just deserve to be equal.
That's right.
People just deserve to have the rights that everyone has when they're born.
Yeah, the founding fathers were really onto something when they penned those words, "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal." But it's not just men. It's women also. And it's all men of all colors everywhere.
All colors.
That is the way forward. If there is one thing that I could easily say is evil, it's slavery, and it is and there's progress to be seen, because the Bible, the Quran, all of the old holy books have rules about how to treat your slaves. We've moved past that, and it's the journey is not over, but it's one that we are continuing to take. So these are difficult times, But it's also a time where we can see a better future, a brighter future, and one that we can build together, where all people are created and treated equally. And that is worth fighting for. That is what the city on the hill is all about. 1,000 points of light and all sorts of things.
Just be good humans.
Yeah. I mean, like, honestly, you could totally distill this to not sucking.
Just be good.
Be less bad.
And
be good.
There's It'll nothing wrong with really feeling like you 100% have it right and that you've totally got it. And you don't have to tell anyone if you ever decide to just maybe listen and learn. You don't have to tell any of your friends if you've decided to just inspect yourself and see if maybe somehow you might just be wrong.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's do a raffle. Sorry. My family's full of preachers, and every once in a while. Okay, so let me put this here. I've never done this live, so I don't know how that works. But
Random number generator.
Dun, dun, dun. We're using the Bonnie Cam. This is a random number generator right here. And we have 18 donations. Guys, thank you so much. That's amazing. Sweet. So I'm going to put this here and I'm going to write in 18. And then we're going to hit generate. Ready? And poof. 10. Number 10 is Leo Ortega. That's awesome. So I'm going to put this over back here.
Hey, Leo, we will be sending you a compact disc.
Yeah, but wait.
Send us your address.
If you're still watching, Leo, you need to tell us, like, if you want to tell us what to write on here. Mm-hmm. Here you go. Can you talk to Leo? Because I dropped the marker.
Hey, Leo. She dropped the marker. You know what I'm saying? And so if you will send us your address,
we
will send this compact disc to you.
You want to sign it?
Yes.
Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll be back again tomorrow night. At least the first portion of tomorrow night's show is going to be pre-recorded, just so you know. We've been lucky enough to be asked by Beto O'Rourke to join him in a Zoom concert tomorrow night so that people that make handmade postcards
For political reasons,
can listen to music while they do it.
Yeah, people who are sending postcards to their representatives, and we're going to play music for that party.
Yeah, it's going
to
be awesome.
So if someone wanted to attend that or find out more about it?
I'm going to post all the information on your Facebook.
So you can check out my Facebook to find out what the hell we're talking about.
What are you guys talking about? And then if Leo has anything else he would like written on here, we can do that for you. And we will be doing these drawings every time. So go ahead and make plans to join us if you're like, I'm going to win some stuff. Do y'all need anything else on here? Oh, Jen White wants to know what the raffle's for.
Oh, the raffle is for this compact disc. So we'll be doing more raffles at our shows. So if you're the type of person who needs to win things.
Or what's the raffle for is basically for us to have money.
Yeah.
What we're doing is
food and
people
shelter.
People that make a donation
make sure that
to
the
us
girls have food, stuff like that.
During each show. We'll do one raffle for each show. Everyone that donates gets a number and they get put on a list. And at the end, we'll draw a number and we'll sign it and send it to you. So we're getting crafty. We'll see you guys tomorrow night. Peace.